The Sabbath was over, and it was almost daybreak on Sunday, when Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to see the tomb. Suddenly a strong earthquake struck, and the Lord's angel came down from heaven. He rolled away the stone and sat on it. The angel looked as bright as lightning, and his clothes were white as snow. The guards shook from fear and fell down, as though they were dead. The angel said to the woman, "Don't be afraid. I know you are looking for Jesus, who was nailed to a cross. He isn't here. God has raised him to life, just as Jesus said he would. Come see the place where his body was lying. Now hurry. Tell his disciples that he has been raised to life and is on his way to Galilee. Go there and you will see him. That's why I came to tell you." The women were frightened and yet very happy. As they hurried from the tomb and ran to tell his disciples, suddenly Jesus met them and greeted them. They went near him, hold on to his feet, and worshiped him. Then Jesus said, "Don't be afraid. Tell my fathers to go to Galilee. They will see me dead." Jesus' 11 disciples went to a mountain in Galilee where Jesus told them to meet him. They saw him and worshiped him, but some of them doubted. And Jesus came to them and said, "I have been given all authority in heaven and on earth. Go to the people of all nations and make them my disciples. Baptize them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and teach them everything to do everything I've told you. I will be with you always, even until the end of the world." You know, the wonderful thing about that is that's at the ascension. Jesus ascended into heaven with the promise that he would return for us one day. And it's a thing that we forget about. You know, the Bible, we like rewards. You know, people like to think about what are our rewards going to be when we get to heaven. And the Bible actually lists 7 rewards, 7 crowns. They're not crowns. You know, some of our hymnals, they were pretty things, you know. They might remember that song, "I Got a Log Cabin Down by the River in Heaven." Yeah. I don't think there's log cabins there. Don't want to hurt your feelings. That's exactly true. And then there's the wonderful song, "Will There Be Any Stars in My Crown?" And the problem with that is that we will never touch a crown like that. We won't. See, the crowns that we're going to be given are like, I was really proud of this at the Greek Olympics, the Greece Olympics a few years ago. You remember that each of the people, when they won, or second or third, they got those leaf things that were around their heads? Okay, that's what the biblical word crown means. And when it says that you're going to receive a crown, Jesus is going to give us, there's an opportunity for us to achieve 7 crowns. And one of the crowns that touches me the most is for people who pray every day that Jesus would return today. That they just can't wait to be with Jesus. That each day as they think and the excitement, Advent, this is the season of Advent, the coming of Christ, and people are excited about the second Advent, the second coming of Christ. They want to be with Christ. They want to live with God. They want to be in heaven. And sometimes we fall short because, you know, we think it can't get much better than this. Right? I mean, did you ever have a food that you love? I became a diabetic. And when I became a diabetic, they told me that I had to drink Diet Pop or my iced tea couldn't have sugar. I drank Southern iced tea, if you know what it means. Southern iced tea is just that short in maple syrup with ice in it. You know, a cup and a half of sugar and a gallon of iced tea was what we did as kids. It's what my mom made. And the thing of it is that then you get all excited because they give you sweet love. And then they tell you all the diseases that's causing them rats. Right? And then it's going to be bad for you. They give you Diet Pop. And, hey, this Diet Pop sounds really good. And they say, yeah, well, you're killing yourself with it. And then you realize that all the things you're going to get excited about can be bad for you. Because it's earth. And earth has been condemned. One of the punishment of sin, that someday Jesus will come and give us all. And he will totally lift that curse. The Bible says lift that curse, and as John sees that all, that one of the next to last verses in the book of Revelation is that John, after seeing all the horrors of the Revelation and all the things that happened in tribulation before after the rapture of the church and before Jesus said to come, John says, "Please come soon, Lord Jesus." And as we're in Christmas, that should be our thought. You know, they prayed so hard for the Messiah to come, and we should truly desire the Messiah to come again. We should truly desire for Jesus to be with us. And I'm going to sing a song that we kind of change the words to. And it's about praying and hoping that Jesus will come soon. Hi, guys. And in the tradition of Christmas, we give you the little number. Just kidding.
Bells will be
the way it was meant to be, the way we were built. I don't know about the rest of it. I've been cooking Christmas cookies and party mix and stuff all week and trying to do all that other stuff, and I can't move. I can't. I'm serious. It's ladies, I haven't done a lot of baking over the years. You deserve a big hand. Guys, if you don't do any baking, you tell the ladies how thankful you are and let them teach you next year, and you will find out what it's like to go to the gym. Okay? You cook that party mix, you got to take it out every 5 minutes and shake it in the roaster. You know, and it doesn't matter what song you put on, it still hurts. And bad stuff. But all that's what deserves is imperfect. Someday we will work hard and do all those things. No pain, no suffering, all because of Jesus. Tonight we're going to do something a little different. We're going to dim the lights, act like candles, and the guys will be around to light your candles. And because we just sang Silent, we just sing a beautiful version of that. We're going to sing, Oh Holiness. And once we get the candles done, we'll start singing. Leslie will just kind of move through that role as long as she can.
with family and friends. Be safe and think often of Jesus Christ and the reason that we truly are celebrating his prayer. God, we just thank you so much for what this day means and how we're celebrating. Lord Jesus, we thank you for the gift you gave us of your life, for the teaching, the loving, and the gift of eternal life that came through your name. We ask that you share this message with everyone that we touch and see. And tomorrow be the day that we spend glorifying you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Oh, come let us adore him.
Sweater with a C instead of an SC. Merry Christmas.